Today at Africanada TV, we are very privileged to receive one of the best singers in Africa, Janet Otieno, from Kenya to Canada. Janet.
Yes.
How are you doing?
I'm doing fine, thank you.
How has it been since you are here in Canada?
It has been quite awesome. Mm. I love it. I love Canada. Mm-hmm. My stay here has been wonderful. Mm. And I also came at a very good time when there is no cold. It's not really cold. And I love it. I love everything about it. I've been received well with a lot of ministers of the word. Mm. The pastors has really welcomed me well in this place.
Can I first know what brought you here in Canada?
Yeah. I came to Canada for the Vega Awards. Mm. I was invited to be one of the artists who are going to grace the occasion. Mm. And that's why I came here.
As many of our viewers, they don't know who you are. First of all, can you tell us a little bit about your childhood?
Mm-hmm. My childhood, I grew up as just like any other child out there. Mm. In a very humble background. My parents were very good Christians. Mm. And so they brought me up in a Christian way of life. Mm-hmm. And that actually introduced me to the church activities. Mm. And I thank God for that.
Can we know it was about what time when they introduced you to the church activities?
I was actually a very young girl. I think at the age of 8 years, mm. I was already in church doing, you know, Sunday school, doing all these things that the other children are doing. And mm. from there, as I grew up as a teenager, mm. I was involved in church activities like singing in the choir and, you know, and doing such things.
So, and that's how you came to become a singer.
Yes.
When did you decide to be like a professional singer?
Yeah, I've been singing in church for quite some time as a choir member. Mm. But up to 2013 is when I got that call to come to sing as a solo artist. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's when I started singing as a solo artist in 2013.
Mm. Yeah. You probably have been to many many families here. You met many people here in Canada. Mm. And probably you have heard some stories of how our African families, many of them, they are here. As a woman, okay, if you had a word to tell a woman of Africa origin or any other woman, what can it be?
What I can tell any other woman out there is just to believe in yourself. Mm. Not to look down to yourself. Believe that you are somebody that God loves so much. Mm. And you have, so I tell everybody that they have so something something wrapped inside them. Mm. It's just upon you to bring it out and unwrap it and make use of it. So I tell them not to look down at themselves and know that they are really, really, really loved by God.
I know also you, as a singer, you travel a lot. Mm-hmm. Maybe within Kenya, Africa, and now here you are in Canada. Mm-hmm. How do you manage the family business and your career of singer?
Planning is just like any other thing in life. Mm. You know, when you have something that you're supposed to do, you know how to plan yourself. I am a mother, I'm a wife.
Mm. You're a mother of children, how many?
Yes, I have three children, two girls and a boy. Mm. God has blessed me with such a beautiful family, I thank him. Mm. And planning for the for everything has... when I started singing, it was quite a challenge, but as I continue doing it, I always know that everything is just about planning. You need to know what falls where and at what time, and once you get to know about that, everything else will just go to. So it's just about planning.
Yeah, again, still as we in Canada, did Canada inspire you any song already?
Yes, I've already inspired by a lot of things, actually. It's just a matter of sitting down and putting those lines down there, but I get inspired a lot.
So, which means for our viewers, next song
yes.
of Janet
Otieno, you inspired by him.
Remember, it has been inspired in Canada. We don't know if she's going to talk about some winter inside, but anyway, the time she came is very beautiful.
It's a beautiful time, actually.
We still have some sun outside, so we bless God to have you at this time.
Amen.
We are right now in the Welcome Holy Spirit Church.
Mm-hmm.
You was the special guest of today.
Oh, yeah.
How did you find it?
I find it really, really a blessing.
Mm.
It's a place, the warm welcome, you know, and I felt this connecting to the Spirit of God in this church.
Mm.
It's a beautiful place to be in. Definitely, if I was supposed to be here, I would just come and fellowship here, you know.
Oh, you welcome.
Yes. I loved everybody.
I will tell Pastor, my Pastor Silva Amber, and he'll be very happy.
Yes.
Well, he's watching us right now, Pastor. Mm-hmm. So anytime she comes to Canada, please.
Yes, please make me to be one of the members here, please.
Mm.
Yeah, it's a beautiful place. I love it. The people here are so welcome.
Mm.
And I am so, so grateful for the man of God. And I say, God just bless you.
You just started singing in 2013. Sometimes they say easy come, easy go. So I said, as she just is just 5 years and she's known already everywhere, because I know people, some of the artists, they take long time before they can even be known in their own country.
Mm-hmm.
It hasn't been the same for you.
Yes.
That's why I said, are you not afraid that you're gonna fall fast also?
No, I'm not afraid. You know, when you know whom you are working for, who has called you in whatever you are doing, you don't be, you know, you're not supposed to be afraid of anything. You just have to put everything to God and know that the calling is His, you know. And so when you are doing it, you don't be afraid, or you don't feel like, you know, I can stop singing or something. No, it's not in my vocabulary. I do it knowing that I'm doing it for God, and I know that the Lord has blessed me with songs, and I will continue doing it and doing it and doing it again and again. So it's not a worry, it's not I just need to keep to give everything to God.
In 5 years, how do you see yourself?
In 5 years, God has really done a lot to me, I must say. He has blessed me. He has taken me with a certain speed, His own speed, I must say, because it's not my doing. If it was about my doing, I couldn't have been here, you know. So God has really done a lot for me within these 5 years, and I'm so grateful. And I believe and I know that He's still going to do a lot for me. He has a lot in store for me, and I'm looking forward to it.
We're very happy and... We're grateful to God to have you here with us here in Canada.
Yes.
I just want to know if you have a last word for your fans here in Canada and around the world.
Yes, my last word to everybody out here is just a question that I would want you to ask yourself. Like, if Jesus was to come back today, what is your relationship with Him? Do you have that personal relationship with Him? Do you know Him? What is the personal relationship with God? So as we probably going to wind up this, just ask yourself, and you know the answer. If your relationship is not so good with Him, just make a point of getting to know Him. Yes.
That's all for today. My name is William Muyuku from Africa Canada TV and Ovira Online. God bless you.